One way to solve this problem is to look at the possibilities. We know that there's a bigger number, the median, and a smaller number. And that we have three inputs, let's call them A, B, and C. Let's say, for the sake of example, that we figure out B is the bigger number. We could solve this using the bigger function that you defined in lecture. From here, we only need to figure out what is the median and the smaller number. We know B can't be the median because we decided that it was the bigger number. From here, all we have to do is compare A and C. There are two cases at this point. One is where A is greater than C. If A is greater than C, we know C is the smaller number, and A is the median. If C is greater than A, we know that A is the smaller number, and C is the median. We can use this strategy to solve every possible case when defining our function. So let's take a crack at it by going right to the interpreter. So first, let's define our function. As specified in the problem, it's called median, and we take in three parameters. As I did before, we're going to call them A, B, and C. As I described earlier, we want to find the biggest number first. Let's call it big. Here's the perfect time to use the function that we defined in class, biggest. Biggest will give us the biggest number, as the name describes, by simply passing in the three parameters. From here, we enumerate the possible cases. As I described earlier, if A is the biggest number, we want to return the bigger number of B and C. If B is the biggest number, we want to return the bigger number of A and C. And lastly, if C is the biggest number, which is satisfied by the else here, we want to return the bigger number of A and B.